Om Jnana Timarandasya Gyananjana Shamakaya Chatsur Nivitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namam Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Komodavani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So we are going through the Brihad Bhagavad Amrita, the second part, and we heard about the travels of Gop Kumar, a cowherd boy from Govardhan, who traveled through the material world and then into the spiritual world and went to Goloka, and he's come back to Vrindavan.
我们现在在聆听的是大伯加瓦檀纲目第二部分这部书，讲述的是高尔丹山的一位牧牛童高帕库马尔的旅行。他在整个物质世界穿越了物质世界之后，进入到灵性世界，又从灵性世界又一直上升到格洛克文达文，最后他又从格洛克回到了地球上的文达文。
Gop Kumar had been giving instruction to a brahmana from Mathura.
Sorry, Maharaj. The host, Krishna Kumar, asked me to say the beginning words of this Vaikuntha.
Oh. Okay.
Vaikuntha Jinfu Yuan Ting今天是2021年7月6日，我们又荣幸的邀请到了圣巴比维克努纳什纳斯恩索玛给我们讲述今天大伯加瓦唐甘露，敬请聆听哈利克什纳。Somebody said, okay, Tom, I began.
Because
they want to record this. So they have to record the days, month.
Okay. So now we have Uttara talking to her son Parikshit. Uttara's mother, and she had inquired about any place higher than Vaikuntha, beyond Vaikuntha. And so she'd heard from Parikshit about Goloka. So Parikshit was describing to his mother about the glories of Goloka. And he tells her how Goloka is, in Goloka you can have eternal contact, you can enjoy eternal loving contact with Krishna.
在 Goloka 人可以跟 Krishna 进行永恒的爱的接触。
So Parikshit said, I've told you everything now about Goloka, and I've answered your question. I think all your doubts should now be removed.
Parikshit 王告诉他的母亲，我现在已经给你详细的描述了一切，我已经回答了您提出的问题，我想您的疑惑已经完全消除了。
Parikshit had told his mother what she had to do, and he wants to remind her that Goloka is the final goal.
Parikshit 告诉母亲她应该做什么，并且告诉她 Goloka 才是终极的目标。
And she should meditate on Goloka, and it will help her to progress.
Uttara 应该冥想 Goloka， 这可以帮助他取得进步。
Originally, Uttara had asked Parikshit, she'd asked him, please deliver me.
一开始的时候 ，Uttara 请求 Parikshit 他的儿子，请拯救我。
So Parikshit had responded, and he told her everything directly.
Parikshit 就回答了。
He satisfied her and removed.
Uttara 已经详细地了解了 Goloka 的情况，因此他内心的疑惑已经现在没有了。
So Goloka is.It's above Vaikuntha, and it can be achieved only by very strong love for the lotus feet of Krishna.
Goloka 在 Vaikuntha 之上，而且只能通过对 Krishna 莲花族的强烈的爱，才能达到那里。
So in Goloka, you get rewards, you get what you cannot even imagine beyond our desires, far beyond any of our desires we can get.
In Goloka, 人获得的回报是远远超越了一个人能够渴望的。
And if we meditate on the people who live in that place, Goloka, then that will give us love of God.
倘若人要是冥想居住在 Goloka 星球上的人们的情况，他就能够获得对神手的爱。
So the only practice or sadhana which we can do to reach that Goloka is to develop this love for Krishna.
要想达到 Goloka, 唯一需要去实践的就是发展起对 Krishna 的爱。
And that love is only there in the residents of Goloka, the people who live with Krishna in Goloka, they all have that love.
In Goloka and Krishna, the people who live there all have Krishna's love.
So we have to remember these devotees, these people who are.Living with Krishna and Goloka, who are Krishna's eternal associates, and by remembering them, that's the key to success.
We need to remember that Goloka and Krishna are the devotees who are Krishna's eternal companions. 一念他们将使一个人达到成功。
you know, people like Nanda Maharaj, Mother Yashoda, the gopis, the cowherd boys, they all have this love of Krishna.
Nanda Dajin, Yashoda, Mother Yashoda,
Gopis, so Parikshit has answered his mother's question by telling her two histories. Right, this book, Brihad Bhagavatamrita, is actually in two parts. There's two stories. Now, one was about Narada, and this other one, which we've been reading just now, this is about Gop Kumara, the cowherd boy from Govardhan.
Brihad Bhagavatamrita, 大波迦塔坦纲录这本书有两部分组成，是由两段历史组成。第一段是有关于Narada的，而第二段历史是有关于高尔丹山的牧牛童Gopakumar的历程。
So Parikshit said, he said to his mother, I could satisfy your request, your question, by telling you about the opinion, what the scriptures say. So he said, now that's what we're going to do. We're going to tell you some of the different things which are said in the scriptures describing the glories of Goloka. So he says, above heaven is Brahmaloka. Above the heavenly planets, where the demigods live, is Brahmaloka, where there are many Brahmarishis, means very great sages. And it is the goal of Lord Shiva and his wife Uma, and also great souls who are all liberated in the Supreme. They all want to go there. So we're going to hear some prayers which were offered to Krishna by Lord Indra after Krishna picked up the Govardhan Hill. We should understand how the universe can be divided into three different divisions. There's the lower planets, which are like the legs of the Supreme Lord. And then the middle planets in the universe are like the navel of the Lord. And the upper planets, which are like Swarg, where the demigods that live, that's like the chest of the Lord. So this Swarg, this is not only the demigods live there, but there's five different planetary systems all up there above Indra, even above Indra, where Indra lives. And it goes all the way up to where Brahma lives.
Um, 在这五个高等的星宿体系之上呢，是 Brahma Loka。
And above Brahma Loka, then that's the end of the material universe.
到了 Brahma Loka， 在 Brahma Loka 之上面呢，就是整个这个物质宇宙就终止在这个地方了。
And above that is Vaikuntha。So Vaikuntha sometimes is also called Brahma Loka because it's the abode of pure spirit. So Brahman means spirit, so sometimes Brahma Loka is another name of Vaikuntha.But of course,
纯粹的灵魂被称为 Brahman， 因此 Vaikuntha 有时候被称为 Brahma Loka。
Of course, Vaikuntha is the place where the personality of Godhead, Lord Krishna, rules.
神手 Krishna 的领域。
So above the five different planets which are at the top of the universe.You come to the covering of the universe, and there are seven coverings. So there
are,
planetary systems.
Above the five planet system is the covering of the universe,
yeah.
And it's consists of ten.
Seven coverings. Seven coverings.
Seven coverings. Okay. 在五个不同的星宿之上面是宇宙的外壳。宇宙的外壳是由七层组成的。
And above these coverings, that's the abode of liberation, right? The place where people get liberation. Go there. They go beyond the covering of the universe.
而在这七个外壳之上面是解脱的居所，那就是那些解脱的灵魂他们的目的地。
And then we come to Shiva Loka, the place of Lord Shiva, and then you come to the spiritual world.
然后在这个之上，在解脱的居所之上呢？就是 Shiva Loka， 住 Shiva 的居所，在住 Shiva 的居所之上面，就是灵性世界了。
So, the heavenly planets, that's where all the pious people go.
天堂星宿是那些虔诚的灵魂们他们所去的地方。
So we want to understand how great Vaikuntha is and how it's far beyond the heavenly planets.
我们要明白白昆塔无休星宿的伟大之处，它远远高于天堂。
There's so many other things between the spiritual world and heavenly planets.
在灵性世界和天堂之间，有许许多多的这个不同的星系。
So Krishna is not simply just Brahman, Krishna is the Supreme Brahman.
Krishna is 不仅仅是 Brahman, Krishna is 至尊的 Brahman.
That was described in the Bhagavad Gita.
这一点在《薄伽梵歌》当中予以了描述。
and Lord Krishna himself in the Bhagavad Gita says, he describes his opulence. He says he is a super soul seated in the hearts of all living entities. So, devotees, we can also say that the impersonal Brahman is also one of Lord Krishna's vibhutis. And there's 1,000 names of Lord Vishnu, and from the 1,000 names of Vishnu, we can see that Krishna is actually the Supreme Brahman. So the word Vaikuntha, of course, is eternal. These planets are all eternal. It's never annihilated.
Vaikuntha, 无忧星宿, 是永恒的, 永远不会毁灭.
So this word Brahma Loka is also Vaikuntha.
因此, Brahma Loka 这个词就是指的是Vaikuntha 无忧星宿。
So those who are Brahma Rishis, the great sages who are fixed in Brahman, there's two types.
那些 Brahma Rishi, 也就是专注于 Brahman 范的圣者们, 分为两类。
Some are like Narada, they're very dedicated to Lord Krishna, the Supreme Brahman.
有像 Narada 这样的圣者, 是完全献身于至尊 Brahman, 献身于 Krishna 的圣者们。
And others are just simply absorbed in the impersonal Brahman.
其余的是那些仅仅专注于至尊 Brahman, 至尊梵的圣者。
But to go to the spiritual world is the desire for all the great sages, including even Lord Shiva and his wife. They all want to go to the spiritual world.
灵性世界是伟大圣者们想要去的地方，包括主Shiva和他的妻子们，他们都想去灵性世界。
So people who want to actually enter into the spiritual world, they cannot be, they're not impersonalists, but they're great devotees of Krishna.
他们全部是Krishna的伟大奉献者。
People like Sanat Kumar, one of the four Kumaras, and his brothers, the four Kumaras, they know from their own experience, they know how impersonal liberation is not very important.
像库马尔四兄弟当中的 Sanat Kumar, 们从他们的亲身经验当中知道，非人格的解脱并不是那么重要的。
And Narada Muni and other associates of Lord Narayan, they have the same experience.
To Narayan 的同游 Narada Muni, 他们也有同样的切身体验。
Devotees like Narada and his other devotees of Lord Narayan, they are all residents of the spiritual world.
像 Narada 这样的圣人，他们是以及主 Narayan 的奉献者们，他们全部都是灵性世界的居民。
So they don't have any difficulty to enter into Vaikuntha.
他们可以轻而易举的就能够进入到 Vaikuntha 无忧心所。
So the spiritual world is far beyond the sun and the moon.
灵性世界远远的高于太阳、月亮。
And there's many planets between the sun, like the sun and the moon. They're higher planets, they're heavenly planets. But there's many other planets before you come to the spiritual world.
月亮都属于高等星宿，但它们都属于天堂。但是在进入到灵性，想要从那里进入到灵性世界，它们中间还有着许许多多各式各样的星球。
Yeah, there's planets like Mahaloka and Janaloka and Tapaloka.
例如 Mahaloka, Janaloka, Tapaloka.
And then you come to Satyaloka, where Lord Brahma resides.
再往上面就是主 Brahma 居住的 Satyaloka.
So the sun and the moon, they cannot even go to Satyaloka. They cannot even go to Brahmaloka, where Brahma lives. So they cannot go to Vaikuntha.
像日月，他们都不能进入 Satyaloka Brahma 的居所，更何况去 Vaikuntha 呢？
So above Brahmaloka is the planet of the cows, which is protected by the Sadhyas.
在 Brahmaloka 之上边是母牛的星球。这个星球由 Sadhya 所保护着。
And that planet expands infinitely.
那个星球可以无限的扩展。
It pervades the spiritual sky.
那可以遍透弥漫整个的。
So that planet's above all other planets.
那个星球是高于任何其他星球。
And to go there, you have to really concentrate. You have to have a very strong desire in your heart.
谁要想去那里，必须是有非常的全神贯注、专注。并且内心怀着强烈的愿望。
And none of us can understand that place, although we have asked about it from our grandfather.
none of us will understand it, although we have asked by our
grandfather. Yeah, we asked our grandfather about it, but he also couldn't tell us about it.
我们都不能理解，我们曾经问过我们的祖父们，他们也不能给我们讲述。
because Vaikuntha is unlimited, so there's nothing beyond it in terms of time and space. But still, Goloka, the planet of the cows, lies above Vaikuntha.
尽管如此, 母牛的星宿, 和乌洛克, 甚至都超越了百昆塔之上。
Just like Shiva Loka is considered above the place of liberation.
正像 Shiva Loka, 主 Shiva 的星球, 它超越了解脱之地。
And Vaikuntha is also considered to be above Shivaloka.
同样的, Vaikuntha, 无忧星宿, 也超越了Shivaloka.
And in the same way, Goloka is above Vaikuntha.
以同样的方式, Goloka 在远远在Vaikuntha之上。
Now, if we say that Goloka is above Vaikuntha, because only on Goloka does Krishna's Lila Shakti show its perfect pastimes. only in Goloka does Krishna perform his very special pastimes. So we may say that is why Goloka is above Vaikuntha. So Goloka, in Goloka there's many of these sadhyas. The sadhyas means Krishna's greatest devotees. People like Nanda Maharaj and others. And great personalities like Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva and Narada Muni and Sanat Kumar, they all want to try to follow. They want to come to their level. They're not on the level of Nanda Maharaj. So the cowherd men and the cowherd women of Goloka, they bring Krishna under their control because of their very special love for Krishna. So these sadhyas are people also like the gopis. Of course, Srimati Radharani, she's the head of the gopis. And Krishna's very, very dear devotees.
Radharani
and they maintain that place, Goloka, and they arrange for all of Krishna's pastimes, wonderful pastimes, so that everybody can know about the wonderful place that Goloka is. Ordinary demigods, they have their heavenly body, but they cannot even travel to Brahmaloka. They cannot go up to Brahma's planet, Satyaloka. They cannot go into Vaikuntha. So there's no way they can ever go to Goloka. So Goloka expands unlimitedly. It's full of eternity, knowledge and bliss. The material world is limited, but the spiritual sky is unlimited. Just like the sky pervades the material world, as long as the universe exists. So Brahman is also all-pervading and eternal. So Goloka is the supreme abode. It's far above all other places. Just like it's very difficult for conditioned souls to understand Vaikuntha, Goloka is even more difficult to understand. Goloka can only be understood by great austerity, by concentration of the heart. Goloka is not known even to the great sages. Even these great sages, they go to the grandfather of the universe. The grandfather of the universe means Lord Brahma. And they go to Lord Brahma and they ask him about it. But they're not able to know very much, because even Lord Brahma doesn't know much about it. So, pious people who control the mind and senses, they are able to go to Swarga, the heavenly planets. And if people do very intense spiritual discipline, spiritual practice, They may even go up to Brahmaloka. But to go to Goloka, the planet of the cows, is the most difficult. That world, Goloka, was under attack, but Krishna saved it. And Krishna wouldn't let anything happen to the cows.
Krishna 绝不会容忍对母牛所做的任何事情。So
Goloka is the residence of many, mostly of cows, and also the people who take care of the cows.
Goloka 主要就是母牛的星球，以及那些照料母牛的人们居住的星球。Now
heavenly planets, they're easy to go there. You just have to be pious, and you can get to the heavenly planets.
去天堂是容易的，只要是虔诚的人都可以去天堂。And
if they control their minds and senses, they can go into the higher planets.
他们控制自己的感官心意，就可以去高等星球。
And somebody may not be so good at controlling the mind and senses, but still they can go to the lower heavenly region. That's called the, there's a heavenly planets which is in the lower part of the universe. So people who are not very good at controlling the mind and senses, they can go there.
脚低的区域，有一个天，有一部分天堂，它是居住在宇宙当中的脚低的区域，就这些人们，他们可以去那里。But
Vaikuntha, the only people who can go there are the perfect Vaishnavas.
而只有完美的 Vaishnava 才可以去 Vaikuntha.
People who Vaishnava means people who concentrate their mind on the Supreme Lord, on the personality of Godhead. And they always engage in spiritual activities and they have pure love for Krishna. So compared to the higher planets of the material world, or even the spiritual planets of Vaikuntha, Goloka is the highest.
比起物质世界里的高等星宿，以及灵性世界的Vaikuntha, Goloka 是最崇高的地方。
And the one who goes to Goloka, they will never come back to this world.
一旦去了Goloka, 就永远不用再回到这个物质世界了。So Goloka
is not only the home of the cows. There are also the cowherd men and the cowherd women, the gopas and the gopis that take care of the cows.
Goloka 不仅仅是母牛的星球，也是照料母牛的 gopa 牧牛郎以及牧牛女们的星球。So
these gopas and gopis, these people are the sadhyas, and they protect the planet, they protect the cows, take care of the cows, and protect everything. So, just as Gokula is in the district of Mathura on the earth planet. So it's also named after the cows. Yeah, and there's also many cows there, and there are many of the cowherd people taking care of the cows. So there's also people who have different relationships with Krishna. Not everybody is just taking care of the cows, there's other people also. Yeah, the devotees. And devotees in different positions doing different services for Krishna. So Lord Indra, he admits that he tried to disturb the peace of Krishna's place, because Indra, right, he sent all the rain clouds to destroy Vrindavan and to kill all the cows and all the people of Vrindavan. So Indra said he admits he tried to stop, to disturb the peace of Krishna's place. But Goloka is transcendental, and Goloka is never, nobody's allowed to go there to give trouble there in Goloka. So Indra, he's not really aware about Goloka. And so he thought that he created trouble there in Goloka, but actually he couldn't give any trouble to Goloka. Yeah, he imagined that when he attacked Gokula, on earth, so he imagined that he was also giving trouble and causing anxiety to people in Goloka. So this was Indra's mistake. He didn't know the real position of Goloka above everything. Then there's a statement by Lord Krishna to Arjuna. And Lord Krishna is saying to Arjuna, he's saying, in many different forms I move about here on earth, and also on Brahmaloka and in the eternal Goloka. So Krishna had been speaking about his different incarnations, including Lord Jagannath in Purushottam Kshetra.
Krishna讲的是他不同的化身，包括在Purushottama Kshetra，居住在那里的Jagannath。
So in Goloka, Krishna appears as in the eternal spiritual world. But there's another planet of cows which is in the material world.
然而在物质世界还有一个母牛的星球。
After Krishna had picked up the Govardhan Hill and protected all the cows, then Indra came with Mother Surabhi to offer prayers to Krishna to apologize.
主 Krishna 举起了高丹山，保护了母牛之后，Indra就带着
Indra knew that if he just came on his own, Krishna would probably ignore him. So Lord Brahma told him, you go with Mother Surabhi, you take Surabhi with you, and Krishna will speak because he likes Surabhi.
Krishna就会不理睬他，所以 Brahma 就告诉 Indra 让他带上 Surabhi 母牛母亲，然后这样因为 Krishna 喜爱 Surabhi， 这样就会跟他讲话。Because
Krishna had protected all the cows, so Surabhi was grateful. She wanted to thank Krishna for protecting all the cows.
因为 Krishna 保护了所有的母牛，所以 Surabhi 母亲
So she came from her residence in the material Goloka. There's a Goloka which is in the material world where all the cows are. And that planet of the cows, that's in the Satyaloka planetary system. Satyaloka is way at the top of the universe. So Indra came there with Surabhi and they did the Abhishek of Lord Krishna, and Mother Surabhi also poured her milk directly from her udder. She poured the milk onto Krishna, bathing Krishna. Yeah, when we go to Govardhan Hill, we will visit that Govinda Kund and we see the place where Krishna and where Indra and Surabhi had bathed Lord Krishna. So Surabhi wanted to thank Krishna how he picked up the Govardhan Hill and he protected all the cows. So that was her way of doing it. So when they did the bathing of Krishna, they made Krishna the Indra of the cows. Indra means the king. So they called Krishna at that time Govinda, the Indra of the cows, or the king of all the cows. So the Goloka, where this Mother Surabhi lives, in the material world, this is the destination of the fortunate cows who don't live in Mathura.
界的 Goloka 是那些没有居住在马图罗区域的幸运的母牛们的居所，那目的地。
So these cows, they don't live in Mathura, so they didn't get a chance to associate with Krishna or with the cowherd boys, but they belong to Brahma and other demigods. So because Krishna is always in Mathura, the cows, they share his pastimes with Krishna and Gokula. So they go to Goloka and they stay in Goloka with Krishna. No, no, because they did get the association of Krishna in Mathura. Yeah, they take part in Krishna's pastimes in Gokula, and then from Gokula they go to Goloka. So now Jaimini is speaking. Jaimini is the son of Maharaj Parikshit. And he's addressing the great sage Jaimini.
Jaimini is addressing Jaimini.
Janmanjaya is addressing Jaimini. Janmanjaya was the son of Maharaj Parikshit, and Jaimini is a sage. So Jaimini says, I'm very happy to hear all these things from you, and you've helped me to understand more about the nature of Goloka. So to understand all these deep statements about the spiritual world, you need the mercy of devotees. So this son of Maharaj Parikshit, he's very grateful to his guru for helping him to hear and to understand about the spiritual world. So he'd heard, he said that, yeah, I can understand, you know, you've told me everything, I think your story is about to come to an end, So I feel very sorry that it's going to come to an end. So I want you to tell me more, give me some more things just to keep me satisfied.
然后他就先生给摘了，就说：“我现在明白，您给我讲了这一切，现在我知道了这个故事将来达到了尾声，所以我感到非常难过。您能不能给我更多的讲述一些，好让我得到满足呢？”
Just like a person who has a fever, then they will be afraid of death.
就好像发高烧的人恐惧死亡。So
the same way, Janmanjaya, the son of Parikshit, he's afraid about coming to the end of his conversation with his guru.
同样的，这Parikshit的房的儿子Janmanjaya，他现在就害怕他跟他的guru的谈话将要达到尾声。
Just like the man with the fever may ask the doctor for some medicine. So the same way, the son of Parikshit, he wants his guru to give him some medicine to keep him alive.
像发高烧的人们会恳求医生给他一些药物，同样呢，Parikshit王的儿子现在就恳求他的医生，恳求他的guru给他一些药物，让他能够继续活下去。
And this medicine, the medicine he wants is some to hear more of the topics about the Supreme Lord and his devotees.
这个药物就是聆听至尊主和他的奉献者更多的活动。
And if he can hear that, then that will make him happy.
他要是聆听了这些活动，他就会感到满心欢喜了。
Of course, that medicine will be through the ear, not through the mouth.
这个药物是通过耳朵得到的，而不是从口中进食的。Okay,
so we will stop now.
好，那现在我们正课的部分就讲到这里。接下来我们看一下问题。
Some questions.
一个问题是 Ravindra Prabhu. 请拜亲爱的Maharaj, Parikshit王连续七天聆听Shukadev Goswami讲述圣典国家法坛。问题是，是七天七夜不吃不睡连续聆听吗？ So Parikshit Maharaj listened the Srimad Bhagavatam from Shukadev Goswami. The question is that, is it that he didn't eat and didn't sleep and continuously listened Srimad Bhagavatam for 7 days and 7 nights?
Yes, that's right.
是的，就是七天七夜不吃不睡连续聆听。周围的众多圣人们也是如此吗？ So there are many sages also listened Srimad Bhagavatam. Did they also fast from drinking and eating and listen continuously for 7 nights and 7 days?
I don't know about that.
关于这些圣人呢，不知道。
We're not told that all the sages were also fasting.
我们并没有得到相关的 信息告诉我们有关于这些圣人们他们的情况。But we're told Maharaj Parikshit
did that.
至少是Maharaj Parikshit王是这样的，七天七夜不吃不睡。Because
he's the one going to die.
因为是Parikshit王将要离开躯体。Now
usually, if a person will not eat or drink for 7 days, they will die. But Maharaj Parikshit didn't die.
通常，倘若谁要是七天七夜不吃不睡的话，就会死去。但是 Parikshit 王并没有死去。
Because he was enjoying the nectar of Krishna Katha.
他在享受着 Krishna Katha, Krishna 话题的甘露。
So that was his food. That was his, gave him life.Hearing the topics of Krishna.
这是他的食物，这个食物就给了他生命，就是聆听 Krishna 的消时光不怕。
Yes.
不可思议，普通人无法理解，非常人之举，聆听有如此壮举吗？昨天伊卡德斯届时都两眼星星闪烁，是否灵修如此精进伟大奉献者能够征服嗜睡呢？可以谢阿布律师呢。He said that it's very inconceivable, for ordinary people to understand, they cannot do this.
Yes.
Is hearing really so wonderful? Because yesterday Ika Desi, I fasted, and I feel.Weak, my eyes are sparkling. So those great devotees, advanced devotees, can. They only they can conquer eating and sleeping. Thank you.
Yes, you're right.
您说对了。
Somehow they live just like the Goswamis.They conquered eating and sleeping.
就像六勾索阿米们，他们是征服了吃和睡眠，进食和睡眠。
And they were always humble, meek and humble.
六勾索阿米们，他们总是恭顺谦卑。
So Maharaj Parikshit, you have to understand, remember he was saved within the womb by the Lord. So he was a very special soul.
我们还要记住，当 Parikshit 王在他母亲的子宫当中，就曾经被 Krishna 所拯救，因此他是一个特殊的灵魂。
He's the grandson of Arjuna.
他是 Arjuna 的孙子。
So father and mother were both very great devotees, not ordinary souls.
他的父母亲都是伟大的奉献者，不是普通的灵魂。
And when he was born,You can read in Srimad Bhagavatam all the predictions which were made about Maharaj Parikshit, his wonderful qualities. Okay.
The next one, 下一个 Rajendra Prabhu, 有关于主 Shiva 的问题。五个，第一 ，Sada Shiva 与每个宇宙的 Shiva 是什么关系 ？So there are continuing five questions about Lord Shiva. The first one is, what's the relationship?Between Sada Shiva and Shiva in each universe?
Well, Sada Shiva is not in this universe, he's in Vaikuntha.
Sada Shiva, 他的居所不在这个物质世界，他居所在 Vaikuntha.
It's a form of Vishnu.
他是 Vishnu 的一个形象。
Yeah,
next. Yes, yes, ma'am.
Yeah, go ahead.
Sada Shiva 居住的地方也叫卡拉是吗? What's the name of the residence of Sada Shiva? Is it also called Kailash?
No.
不叫 Kailash.
Sada Shiva Loka.
Oh, 那名字就叫 Sada Shiva Loka.
Yeah, he has his own planet in the spiritual sky.
他在灵性天空有自己的星球。
Shagavanti.
第三个, Sada Shiva的活动是什么? 使命是什么? What's his activity? What's his mission of Sada Shiva?
Well, he's a form of the Lord in the spiritual world.
Sada Shiva是主在灵性世界的另一个形象。
What's his mission? His mission is to reciprocate with his devotees, the devotees who go there, who worship the Lord and who reside there with him in the spiritual world, in the Vaikunthas. He will be with them and he will, they will associate together and discuss topics of the spiritual world and discuss topics of Lord Krishna.
他的使命是，就是他在他的使命是回报他的奉献者，因为他的奉献者们就去那里崇拜主，他们和他居住在一起，他们和他联谊，他们在一起联谊。
What do any of the just what do all the Vishnu forms do in Vaikuntha? You can read Brihad Bhagavatam. We read the Brihad Bhagavatamrita. We heard about the Lord in Vaikuntha and what the devotees are doing. They chant the holy name. And they all engage in devotional service. And Sada Shiva is there, he is the Lord on that planet, and all the devotees there will worship him. So he will accept their worship and he will satisfy them with nice words.
Sada Shiva is the Vishnu 啥关系? What's the relationship between Sada Shiva and Lord Vishnu?
Well, Sada Shiva is a form of Lord Vishnu. There are many different Vishnu forms. All the Vaikuntha planets, in every Vaikuntha planet, there's a different Vishnu form.
Next, 有人说主 Shiva 属于半神，又说不属于半神. Somebody says Lord Shiva belongs to the category of demigod, but some says no.
Well, Lord Shiva is a very special personality. He's between. Usually, Lord Shiva is not a jiva.
主Shiva是特殊的人物，一般来说，他不是一个jiva个体灵魂。
right? But the relationship between Vishnu and Shiva is the milk and yogurt. That Shiva is the yogurt, Vishnu be milk, and milk can be made into yogurt. So Lord Vishnu can become Shiva, but Lord Shiva never becomes Vishnu. So Lord Shiva is in the category above the demigods.
因此, 主Shiva是, 半神之上面的一个范畴。
We just heard today, he has his abode. It's beyond the covering of the material universe. But it's not in the spiritual world. It's just outside the spiritual world. It's above the abode of liberation. Yeah?
Maharaj, 主持人,恶奉献者, Shiva Loka 距离灵性世界最近, 主Shiva的奉献者, 到 Shiva Loka, 是否很快就去灵性世界呢? Obeisance to Maharaj and the host and all devotees, since Shiva Loka, the distance between Shiva Loka and the spiritual world is the shortest distance, is that the devotees of Lord Shiva can go to spiritual world very quickly?
Yes, but not just any devotee of Lord Shiva can go to Lord Shiva's abode there. Only those who have the proper understanding of Lord Shiva's position can go there.
是的，但不是任何主Shiva的奉献者都可以去灵境世界，只有那些对主Shiva的地位 有着正确理解力的奉献，主Shiva的奉献者才可以去灵性世界。In
the Srimad Bhagavatam, fourth canto, you can read there was a big fight between the followers of Lord Shiva and the followers of Daksha.
圣地伯加瓦坛第四篇当中有一段描述。 是有关于主Shiva的追随者以及Daksha的追随者之间的一场激战。
And they cursed each other. The followers of Daksha, the followers of Daksha were all Brahmanas, and they were cursed to become people who practiced dull rituals of no meaning.
主Shiva的追随者和Daksha追随者彼此互相的诅咒。Daksha的追随者都是婆罗门。
And the followers of Lord Shiva, they were cursed to become atheists.
而主Shiva的追随者们受到诅咒，变成无神论主义者。
And they said both curses are still present today.
据说这两个诅咒现在就是当今年代都仍然在生效。So
most Shivites are atheists. They think that God has no form, He's not a person, they think God is just light.
主Shiva的追随者们，他们认为神无形无相，就是光，没有。
And other people, they're devotees of Shiva to get some material desires, they're just materialists and they just want to get some material blessing.
And
Yeah. So only the real devotees who actually know Lord Shiva's position, they can actually go to that planet.
Only those real devotees who understand Lord Shiva can go to that planet.
Yes, they have to be.
只有那些对主 Shiva 真正的理解了主 Shiva的地位的，主的属Shiva的奉献者才可以去那个星球。
Lord Shiva is a Vaishnava. He's a great devotee, and he worships Lord Sankarshan.
主 Shiva 是一位伟大的 Vaishnava, 是伟大的奉献者, 他崇拜主 Sankarshan.
Okay.
下一个问题。 下一个问题来自于Yuna, Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, and all devotees. Please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Devotees have a negative attitude toward Maya and Kali, but they are doing their service to Krishna. Should we show respect to them in some way? Yuna 问 Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, 所有奉献者请接受千面顶拜，荣耀归于Srila Prabhupada。 奉献者们对于玛雅和卡里都有着负面的想法， 但是他们都在履行各自对 Krishna 的服务， 我们是不是应当以某种方式向他们展示敬意呢？
Yes, we should. We should respect them. Devotees, devotees should be trained to respect the demigods. We should not disrespect any demigods.
我们应当尊敬他们，奉献者们，他们应当得到训练，尊重半神人，而不要对半神人有任何不恭敬心。But
ordinary people, they will worship these personalities to get material blessings.
普通人崇拜这些人物，是为了得到他们，得到一些谋取一些物质利益。
Okay.
下一个问题来自于Shruti Rupa Devadasi. Hare Krishna, 顶拜Guru和老师们，请教Guru，一，在我目前的状态，在没有外在打扰的时候，可能控制心意方面问题不大，但是一旦被打扰，马上就会出现评判、抗拒等心理活动。请问Guru，应当 应该怎样才能把自己的心意训练到稳稳妥妥的Krishna直觉呢？ Two questions from Shruti Rupa Devadasi, Hare Krishna, bassist guru and all teachers. First one is, in my present situation, if there is no disturbance from outside, then there is no problem to control my mind. But as soon as my mind is disturbed, they will immediately be some judgment on the reposal. My mind will, there will be a judgment and reposal in my mind. Rejection. So my question is that, Guru, so what should I do to train my mind so enter into the proper mood of Krishna consciousness?
Well, you have to take the medicine. The medicine is simply the chanting of the holy name. You chant the holy name with great determination and within your mind. You also think of Krishna and pray to Krishna to help you to control your mind.
这药是什么呢？就是去接受圣灵，而且要下定决心，在您的心意里要想着Krishna，您要祈祷Krishna帮助您控制心意。
We know the nature of the mind. Everyone has the same problem with the mind, we have to learn to overcome it.
我们都知道心意的本性，人人都在心意空性方面都有着问题，所以我们要学习怎样征服心意。In
the sixth chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna was describing meditation to Arjuna, and Arjuna said he couldn't do it because his mind was too restless.
在《薄伽梵歌》第六章，主Krishna向Arjuna描述了冥想体系，但是Arjuna回答说，他无法做到，因为心意总是不安不稳。But
Lord Krishna told him, "No, it's possible. You can do it, but you have to practice."
但是主Krishna告诉他，并不是这样的。你是有可能控制心意的。
And you have to also become detached. The problem is we're very attached, our material attachments are very strong. You have to let go.
问题就出在于我们的物质的衣服。
Yeah, we have to learn to surrender. This is all the teachings of the Bhagavad Gita, and we have to surrender and we have to accept everything which happens as Krishna's arrangement.
这是整部《薄伽梵歌》的教导，就是要把一切都当成是 Krishna 的安排。
What's the second question?
Second question is that, 有从来没有接触过修行的新人，问现在听了一段时间的《薄伽梵歌》，还是感觉在听天书，也不想念圣名，请问这是不是罪恶深重的原因呢？ There are some devotees who hasn't any previous practice. Now, this devotee, after reading Bhagavad Gita for some time, still felt that this book cannot understand. It's very mysterious. Cannot understand anything, and also the new party don't have the inclination to chant the holy name. So, is it the reason that the new party had a lot of sin, because very sinful?
Well, most people are in a similar condition.
情况比较类似。
You have to help them to start. You have to have kirtan with them. You have to do chanting with them. You have to help start with a little kirtan, and by kirtan, gradually they will get a taste for chanting.
您必须要帮助这些新人，跟他们一起 kirtan。您要跟他们一起唱诵。
让他们逐步发展出对唱诵的、念诵的品味。Yeah, people often don't like to sit and chant with beats, but they can join the kirtan with the devotees chanting and dancing even. Then they find pleasure, they will take pleasure in that chanting.
大部分人不喜欢呆呆地坐在那里念诵，坐下来念诵，但是他们喜欢 跟奉献者一起 kirtan， 然后在 kirtan 当中呢，就是跳舞，快乐的跳舞。And
somebody reads the Bhagavad Gita, they say they can't understand it. You have to help them understand it. You have to read with them. You have to explain it to them. You have to sit with them and go through it with them, read together, and you explain to them what being done, what's happening. Otherwise, very difficult for people to understand.
大部分读国家放歌的人都不明白在讲的是什么，那您就得需要帮助他们了，您需要给他们解释，跟他们坐下来一起来读这部书，给他们解释到底发生了什么事情，否则的话很难理解。
This is true everywhere, not just there, not just in your place, everywhere in the world. People have difficulties to understand sometimes. They need help, they need association. This is what association is for.
这个是全世界各地的普遍现象，他人们呢就是会有一段时间呢很难理解，所以呢你就奉献者就得帮助他们，跟他们联谊，这就是联谊的意义所在。Association
will help people come into Krishna consciousness.
联谊可以帮助人们走进 Krishna 之觉。
So you have to help them, give them, let them have join the kirtan, and they will hear people chanting, and they will see also how it's in pleasure, and it's not difficult, and gradually they'll start to do it.
所以呢，您就得帮助他们，让他们加入进 kirtan。 让他们聆听这个唱诵的音阵，然后当他们看到奉献者这么快乐，他们就觉得不难了，然后逐渐的他们就可以开始理解了。And
you have to also help them understand the books. Maybe you get some smaller book. Maybe Bhagavad Gita is a bit too difficult for them. So you start with one small book like Beyond Birth and Death, and then. It's just some small book, and you read it together and discuss it.
那为了帮助他们理解这个《国家梵歌》这部大部头的书呢，您可以给他们先看像《超越生死》这样小书，然后跟他们一起来朗读，然后呢接下来就讨论这个书里的内容。
Yeah. Okay.
请问这种状态下应该怎样才能培养起对 Krishna 这句信心呢？You have maybe answered the question, next part of the questions that how under the circumstances how can I help them to cultivate the faith in Krishna consciousness?
Yes, if you have faith yourself, then you'll be able to give to them.
是的，如果您自己信心满满的，就可以把信心给予他们了。We
get faith by associating with people who have faith.
通过和那些信心满满的人联谊，就能获得足够的信心。So
you have to guide them properly. You have to help them to understand the books. You have to help them to get a taste for the holy name by kirtan.
所以呢，您需要指导他们明白理解这部书，并且帮助他们获得对 kirtan 的品味。下一个是来自于那拉伊恩姐姐，礼拜姑，我的舅婆前两天离开躯体，前几天舅婆就处于昏迷。 昏迷状态，在这样的情况下，24小时不间断给他听 Hare Krishna mantra， 听国家梵歌对他有帮助吗？老人前几天看起来很痛苦，离开躯体的时候看起来很安详，而且很认真的听 mantra， 离开躯体的时候像睡着了，这是 mantra 起作用了吗？是礼拜姑奉献的莲花足。Obeisance to Guru， 舅婆 ，My。 舅妈是舅妈吧 ？My uncle, aunt-in-law, 2 days ago, my aunt-in-law left her body. Several days before, she left her body. She's in coma. She was in coma. So I play Hare Krishna mantra 24 hours for her. And listen, let her listen to Bhagavad Gita. Is that helpful for her? Because several days ago, she looked very painful, but when she left her body, she seems very peaceful, and she even listened to mantra very seriously. Therefore, when she left her body, she seems to go to deep sleep. Is that the effect of the mantra? Obeisance to the Guru and all devotees, the lotus feet of Europe.
Yes, certainly hearing the holy name will help to create a nice atmosphere, and it will evoke the presence of good spirits. The evil spirits would not come where there's the chanting of the holy name.
是的，圣明会创造一个非常良好的氛围，并且圣明的灵在也会召唤至善灵，就善良灵魂的灵在，会驱除邪灵、邪恶的灵魂。
Yeah, where the chanting of the holy name is going on, the servants of Yamaraj will not come to that place.
哪里有圣明？ Yamaraj 的仆人就不会去那里。
Usually, everybody goes to Yamaraj to be punished for their, to be judged for their activities. But if you are chanting the holy name, you don't have to go to Yamaraj.
通常就是每一个人都会临终之后都要去阎罗王那里接受审判，但是。 倘若有圣明，那么这样的人就不用去阎罗王那里接受审判了。She'll
have the opportunity to have association with devotees in her next life.
她在来世就会有机会与奉献者们联谊。 Jin is paying you obeisances and all devotee. Next, Himavati. 请问 Guru, Mahavishnu 与圣 Narayana 有区别吗? 感恩您. Guru, what's the distinction between Mahavishnu and Lord Narayana?
Yeah, Lord Narayana is the form of the Lord in the spiritual world, in Vaikunthas, and Mahavishnu is the Lord who is doing the work of the, he's laying in the causal ocean, and from his body all the universes come out at the time of creation, and at the time of the annihilation everything enters into his body.
主纳拉亚呢，是在灵性世界白昆塔星球上，还居住在那里，而马哈维什努，他是躺在物质世界的元云之阳，从他的身体毛孔散发出无助的宇宙，而在这个宇宙毁灭的时候呢，这些宇宙又再次进入到他的体内。
So Mahavishnu, he is called one of the Purusha avatars. Purusha avatars, they're doing the work of the creation for the material world.
Mahavishnu 也被称为Purusha化身之一。Purusha化身的使命，它就是创造物质世界。
Okay.
下一个是，真真，请问 Guru, 听到赞美还是容易骄傲，听到批评还是会心里难过。该怎么做才能做到对此不依附呢？ So this devotee is just not paying obeisance to you. She asked that although I know it is not good to attach to praise and criticism, but still I cannot be undisturbed by those praising and criticism. As soon as I heard praising, I felt proud. And as soon as I heard criticism, I felt sorry in my heart. So what should I do to become unattached to them?
Yes, you have to chant Hare Krishna more. You have to purify your consciousness.
是的，您需要更多的唱诵 Hare Krishna， 净化您的知觉。
And you already understand that this is not a good situation, that you shouldn't feel proud when you're praised, and you shouldn't lament when you're chastised. But you should accept it as Krishna's mercy, that Krishna is teaching you to be humble.
您已经明白了，就是听到赞美就骄傲，或者听到斥责就内心难过，这样做不好。您应该把他们都接受，把他接受成是 Krishna 的仁慈，再教导您如何变得谦卑。
Yeah, when you're chastised, Krishna is making you humble, so you say thank you, Krishna. And when you're praised,You say, actually, I don't deserve this praise, but Krishna is just trying to encourage me. And you say, thank you, Krishna.
那么当您就是受到斥责的时候呢，您当认为是 Krishna 在教导您要变到谦卑，所以你就应该感谢 Krishna， 对 Krishna 说谢谢。那如果您听到赞美的时候，你应该这么想，就是我不配得到这些赞美，但是 Krishna 在这样的鼓励我，所以，同样的，谢谢你 ，Krishna。
So in every situation, you have to see the hand of Krishna.
您必须在每一个境况之下呢，都看见 Krishna 的仁慈之手。
Okay.
下一个。H， 顶拜亲爱的姑乳，所有奉献者。如果小孩子在吃肉，即使去做专门的注意力训练，是不是也不会达到真正的专注静心呢？要怎样训练他们才可能做到专注聆听呢 ？Obeisance to dear guru and all devotees. If the child is still eating meat, is that?Although we train them specially to concentrate their mind, still they cannot truly, genuinely concentrate their mind and become very peaceful in their heart. So how can we train them to become very attentively in listening?Thank you.
Well, you see, the child is eating meat. This is because of the upbringing, that from the birth, the child was not brought up to be a vegetarian, so he has a habit to eat meat.
就孩子吃肉呢，他就是。从小的时候，他就没有受到这方面的教养，有让他们吃素，所以他们就养成了吃肉的习惯。
The beginning of life was not very auspicious. There was no.
农生。
Yeah, there was no purification. There was no opportunity for the child to develop good qualities or good habits.
所以从生命之初呢，他们的生命之初就不是很吉祥，就没有得到过净化，没有， 养成好习惯，没有培养优秀的品质。
So, how to control, how can a child develop control over the mind?
Become very attentively in hearing.
They cannot.
Concentrate. 那他们这样的这种情况下，他们就做不到非常专注的聆听。
Is that right?
She asked if we send them to be trained in the term of in the field of be very concentrated, give them special training in this regard, and that they cannot become.Truly very concentrated and very peaceful, she asked.
Well, do you have some, does she have some special way of training them?
那姑姑问您，您是不是就是有那种特殊的训练方式呢？ It seems like that. 即便去做专门的训练。It seems like.
Well, the point is the child does not have good habits. He's eating meat. He's not developing proper control over the mind and senses.
最关键就是孩子现在没有养成好习惯。并没有能够发展出对感官和心意的控制。
So you want the child to be sense controlled, to control the mind, to be peaceful.
那您就希望孩子能够控制他的感官，控制心意。
It's going to take some time to see what is the nature of the child. What does he want to do with his life?As he grows, you have to observe and see.
那就需要您需要花一段时间来观察这个孩子的天性如何，观察他长大以后能够去做什么事情。
There has to be, you have to find something which interests a child.If the child is able to absorb himself in some particular activity, then he may be peaceful. The problem is just to find the right activity which he likes to do, which he enjoys. Then he's probably peaceful.
您就需要找到孩子的兴趣点。孩子能够在哪些活动上变得专心致志的从事这个活动。他的内心从而变得平和，去找到适合这孩子的正确的活动，找到孩子的喜好，这样他内心就能平和了。
Anyway, if you have some special program to help the child to concentrate, to improve his concentration.Then get him to do it. Yeah.
那么您呢？如果现在去给他做特殊的注意力训练，有这种项目，那可以，您就可以去这样去做。
Yeah. 下一个问题。
下一个来自于林慧，顶拜的咕噜，所有奉献者，请问咕噜解脱。还是要解脱了，还是要轮回，对吗？这一世要回文达问，需要苦行。请问咕噜，当今年代我们的苦行是什么？是控制心意和承受躯体的疾病吗？请咕噜细讲。哈尔克什的。Obeisance to Guru and all devotees. So, if we get liberated. liberated, then still there has to be reincarnation.
No, liberation means you go beyond birth and death.
那就不需要再轮回了，解脱就意味着已经超越生死了。And she asked that if in this time we want to go back to Vrindavan, there has to be some tapasya. So Guru, what's our tapasya for this age? Is it to control the mind and endure the illness of the body? So please explain it in detail, Hare Krishna.
Yeah, the tapasya for this age is to follow four regulative principles and chant 16 rounds.
这个年代的苦行是遵守四项原则，唱诵念诵十六圈。
This is the tapasya for the Kali Yuga.
这个是卡利年代的苦行。
To strictly follow four principles.
严格地遵守四项原则。
And to chant 16 rounds every day without offense, trying to avoid offenses.
并且，没有冒犯地念诵十六圈，至少是努力地避免冒犯地去念诵十六圈。
That is the tapasya.
这就是我们要做的苦行。
Yes。
下一个来自 S， 请问天堂星宿是包括地球以上的所有星球吗？还是指月球 ？Goloka 和地，So, this devotee asked, is the Svargaloka?Heavenly planets include all planets above the Earth, or only refers to the moon planet?
Heavenly planet, well, the sun and the moon, they're both heavenly planets.
太阳、月亮都属于天堂。
Yeah, there are.Different planets there, above our own planet, and they're considered the heavenly planets.
在我们地球之上呢，有不同的星球，他们被视作天堂。
And then there's planets above the heavenly planets.
在天堂之上还有星球。
When we began reading the Brihad Bhagavadamrita, we described Gop Kumar going to all these different planets.
我们在讲述这《大博伽瓦当甘露》这本书，一开始就讲了Goloka Kumar去了不同的星球。
How he went.First he was on earth, then he went to the heavenly planets, and then he went to Mahaloka, Janaloka, Tapaloka, and then he went to Satyaloka, the planet of Brahma.
他从地球去了天堂，又从天堂又去了 Mahaloka, Janaloka, Tapaloka, 然后又上到了 Satyaloka.就是 Brahma 的星球。
OK。
Goloka 和地球 Vrindavan 有何区别 ？What's the distinction between Goloka and Vrindavan on Earth?
Goloka and Vrindavan on Earth? Well, in Goloka, Krishna's always present.
在 Goloka 就是 Krishna 是时时刻刻的。
But in Vrindavan on earth, Krishna is not always manifest. He's always, he's there, but you don't always, it's not, you can always see him. Only certain times you can see him.
而在地球上的文达文，你是不能总是看到他，就是Krishna，他不是总展示的，他在那里，但是呢，看我们看不见，他只是在特定的时间在展示他自己。Yeah,
like 5,000 years ago, he was manifest.
他5,000年前就在那里展示了他自己。
So usually one time in the day of Brahma, you can see him there in Brahma, in Vrindavan.
通常就在Brahma的一天当中，你可以见到他一次。
下一个，continue.
天女Indra怎么能去地球 Vrindavan? How can Indra go to Vrindavan on Earth?
Well, Indra has a, he has his own carrier, he has a vehicle, he comes to visit. When he sent, at the time when Krishna was present, Indra sent the clouds to inundate Vrindavan. And he said, I'm coming with you. And Indra came with them to see the clouds. But the clouds, they could not do anything. They could not damage Vrindavan because Krishna picked up the Govardhan Hill and protected everyone. When Krishna was on Earth,
Krishna was sent to the Indra, the Lord, to flood Vrindavan. Then he told the Lord, 我会跟你们一起去，所以他就去看这些云所做的工作。但是最后这些云呢，云他没有淹没了Vrindavan，因为主 Krishna 去了Govardhan山，保护了Vrindavan。
So the demigods would come regularly to this planet, but not in Kali Yuga. In Kali Yuga, they don't like to come. People are too sinful.
半神人们呢，他们会有规律的、定期的来。 来地球，但是不是在他里面待，在他里面待，他们不习惯来，因为太罪恶了。下一个是，Atanya Charam，Impada Guru和奉献者，看到瑜伽阶梯有三个，渐进瑜伽阶梯，夜报瑜伽，思辨瑜伽，八步瑜伽，分爱瑜伽，进步瑜伽阶梯，Sakam Yoga，Sakam。 Niskam, Bhava Bhakti, Prema Bhakti, 快速瑜伽阶梯, Sadhana Bhakti, Bhava. The 问题是, 快速瑜伽阶梯, Sadhana Bhakti, Bhava Bhakti, Prema Bhakti, 三者有什么区别? Chaitanya Charanprabhu, paying obeisance to Guru and all devotees, there are three letter of you. There are three levels of yoga ladder. Karma yoga, Jnana yoga, Ashtanga yoga, Bhakti yoga, and also Sakam karma yoga, Niskam karma yoga. There are Bhava bhakti, Prema bhakti, and Sadhana bhakti. So the question is that what's the similarity and distinction? The difference between sadhana bhakti, bhava bhakti, prema bhakti.
Oh. Yeah. Well, sadhana bhakti is devotional service and practice, where we're practicing to follow the different rules and regulations. And sadhana bhakti is using our senses and mind to awaken ecstatic love for Krishna, to come to the higher level of Bhava Bhakti.
Sadhana Bhakti is the Sushing Jung the Kumai Fu. Yao Zunshu, Gosian Guizu, Yao
There are two levels of sadhana bhakti. One is according to the rules and regulations, and the other is spontaneous. According to rules and regulations. So in the beginning we follow the rules and regulations guided by scriptures and the spiritual teacher. But then gradually it becomes more natural and spontaneous. We want to serve Krishna. And Bhava Bhakti is devotional service in ecstasy, where one is very strongly attached to chanting the holy name and to hearing about Krishna and residing in the holy Dham. Bhava Bhakti, one has there are nine principles describing Bhava Bhakti, nine characteristics of somebody who is on the level of Bhava, described in the Nectar of Devotion, chapter number 17 and 18.
《父爱的甘露》这部书的第十七章、第十八章描述了巴瓦的九项特征。Right,
Mita, you don't waste time. You're fully engaged in Krishna's service every second.
到这个阶段，人就不会浪费一分一秒的时间，并且。
And prema bhakti is where you develop love of God and you see everything and everyone in relation to Krishna. So there are all stages of pure devotion. Sadhana bhakti, one who is doing sadhana bhakti, he's also a pure devotee. Bhava bhakti is pure devotee, prema bhakti is also pure, but they're different levels. Yeah. Okay.
好，最后一个问题是，那个一串数字 ，Hare Krishna， 亲爱的 Gurudev， 礼拜您的电话，为什么牧牛姑娘、牧牛童他们和在一起都是感到独自和主在一起呢？这是什么样的心态呢？请教你，感恩 Gurudev。 Dear Gurudev。 Obeys to your lotus feet. Why, when the gopals and gopis they stay with the Lord, they feel that they are with the Lord separately. Only they are with their themselves are with the Lord. What kind of mentality is that? Thank you.
Well, Krishna arranges for them to think like that. It's not that they think like that, but it's Krishna arranges like that.
Krishna
wants them to experience his love for them.
Krishna 希望他们能体验到，他们各自对 Krishna 的爱。
So this is it. This is the pure love of the gopis.
这些是 Krishna 的 gopi 牧牛姑娘对 Krishna 的纯爱。
That they want whatever pleases Krishna, they will accept.
无论什么能够取悦 Krishna, 他们就接受。
And Krishna likes them to think that he's with them, not with the others, that he's only with them. Krishna likes them to feel like that.
Krishna 希望他们认为，就是 Krishna 只和他们在一起，没有在和别人在一起。他是希望他们有这种。
And then Krishna can also test them. He can see, are they becoming proud?
Krishna, 他有时候也考验他们，看他们有没有变得骄傲。
And if he sees they're becoming proud, then Krishna will leave them and disappear.
一旦 Krishna 看到他们有这种骄傲情绪，他就立刻消失了，离开了他们。
So it is Krishna's pastimes, for Krishna's pleasure that he does all these things. Everything which happens is Krishna's plan, Krishna's arrangement for his pleasure.
这些都是 Krishna 的消时光，是 Krishna 出于快乐他们去做的。
And the gopis,
无论是什么，都是 Krishna 的计划安排。
And the gopis' mood is simply servant of Krishna, that they will Krishna's servant in all situations.
Gopi, 牧牛姑娘的心态就是 Krishna 的仆人，在任何情况下都是 Krishna 的仆人。
Okay, so we will stop here. So, you want me to get you a good morning?
Oh, sorry, there's one more question. There's one more question. So, do you want to answer?
什么问题？
下一个就是来自于 Rajarani. Gumar, 你接受我卑微请问，当宇宙有部分毁灭时，下面的和中等星球去哪里？是融进去 Garbha Daksha 与 Vishnu 身体吗？So when there are actually destruction in the universe, where is the destination of the lower and middle planet system? Is it that they merge into the body of Mahavishnu?
Yeah, if it's a partial annihilation. Partial
yes.
annihilation takes place at the end of Brahma's day.So then partial annihilation. And yeah, they will enter in the body of Garbha Dakshayu Vishnu.
In Brahma, the day of the day, there is a part of the destruction. This time, these stars actually entered Garbha Dakshayu Vishnu. Okay, finish.
Okay, Hare Krishna.Woman Ganshi Guru Mani, Matajiki, Woman Fani, Ganshi Sati Maraji, Juju, or Krishna Kumari, Juju, Ganshi Story of Functions at LinkedIn, Jufu Niman Chang Song Kwai La, Bao Zhong Shinti, Wei Si Jin Khan, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
瓦昆特基因服务员林明天，非常非常感谢圣巴迪维维纳什纳辛哈苏阿玛尔给我们带来精彩的导课，感谢所有奉献人耐心聆听我提出的好问题，希望大家能在过日子中过一个愉快的周二。Hare Krishna。
Hare Krishna。